Welcome to this presentation from the Urban Penguin. My name is Andrew Mallett and today we'll look at the Level 1 certification for the LPI, Exam 102, and a little bit of system logging. As always, you can find these videos on theurbanpenguin.com. If you're on Twitter, you can follow me at The Urban Penguin, and on Facebook you'll be able to find and like my page as The Urban Penguin. So let's jump onto the command line of my Ubuntu 12.04 server, and we're going to take a look at the rsyslog daemon. The objectives will have you look at the syslog d, but the reality is probably nobody is using it anymore. SUSE use the syslog ng, and CentOS, Red Hat, Fedora are all using the rsyslogd, which is similar to what we are using here, the rsyslogd on Ubuntu. The configuration is going to be very similar though. So the first thing we're going to do is take a look in the var log directory. And if we do a listing here, this is where we can see our log files. It is really the syslog daemon that is in charge of sorting the information and making sure that the correct information gets filtered through to the correct log file. It doesn't really matter what syslog daemon you're using, the purposes are all the same. The configuration is going to be in the etc directory, so if we revert back to our etc directory, and then if we do a listing of our sys star, we can see we've got the rsyslog.conf, we've got then a syslog.d directory, an extension directory to the configuration file. And that's where most of the work is going to be done. But we'll take our starting view of the rsyslog.conf. So we'll use vi and jump inside the file. Once we're inside the file, the rsyslog.conf, we can see that pretty much in here we are setting up the defaults for the ports that we're going to be listening on and the defaults for setting up permissions for new log files and the ownership, etc. So with this in place, we can see at the bottom there's the include statement where we're including then the main working files from the rsyslog.d directory. So let's take a look then at the 50 default file. So this is a name kind of suggests has most of the defaults for system logging. And we can look at the man page, so rsyslog.conf5, for getting an idea of how to fill it out. The top line, we're really looking at everything from the facility auth and auth priv to be sent through to var log auth log. And on the line below that, everything that's not from auth and auth priv, so auth, auth priv dot none, excludes everything, whereas the star dot star includes everything. The difference where we see where we're being writing to the file, some lines will start with a hyphen and some not. If it starts with a hyphen, we're using the sync buffer, so we're writing to our memory buffers before we write to the disk. If it doesn't start with a hyphen, we're writing directly and avoiding the buffers. So normally on higher priority messages, the emergency messages, those sorts of things are more likely to be written directly. So we're going to start creating a new entry to understand some of the settings that might go into this file. So we can use some of the information that is commented out as guidelines or documentation, whichever way you want to read it. So we'll drop into the insert mode and we're going to put then star.info. So that's from any facility from the info and higher priorities. We can separate entries with a semicolon. Now that will differ from if I put star dot equals info, then we're only looking for the priority of info and nothing higher. So again, just as long as we understand the writing here, so star dot info is info and higher. but we're going to exclude information from auth and auth proof. So we have those as the facilities, and then we use none as the priority. We set our semicolon to separate it, and then we can use mail and news dot none. So mail obviously from the mail facility, news from the NNTP facility. It started off really with these syslog daemons that they thought every facility would have its own service, but often we use local services and assign those local facilities to services. We can see that then we're writing to var log messages, but the hyphen indicates that we are going to use the write buffer. The next line, we're going to use local1.info, so that's going to be info and hire, and we're going to send to var log Andrew. Again, the hyphen indicates that we're going to send it to the write buffers and allow the normal sync process to write to disk. Having saved those changes, we can restart the syslog daemon. And with that ready, we can now test it with the logger command. The logger command is very useful. We can use it for testing, but you also might build it into your scripts so we can have a logging of success and failure of actions that you might script. So logger minus P for our priority, and we're going to use the local one with a priority of warning. Remember, I put local1.info, but that's going to then be info and hire. And we'll just send a hello world message. The Andrew file wasn't there before, but if I take a look at it with the tail command now, so tail minus one var log Andrew, we can see that we've been able to log this message. So we've tested that logging is working the way that we want it. And we could, remember, use this logger command to great extent within our scripts for making sure that we have a logging mechanism. So hopefully we've got an understanding of how we get information into the correct file. And the configuration of the syslog daemon is going to be very similar to the rsyslog daemon. So again, thank you very much, and I look forward to seeing you back on the Urban Penguin channel very soon.